Lesson 12, and name of the lesson is consumer protection. As you can see, so student, this lesson 2 is very short and means in our whole syllabus 2 or 3 lessons are there which are very small, that is, and one was business environment, then controlling, and this one is consumer protection. And this one is very interesting also because means most of us being a consumer, we are having lots of rights as well as responsibilities also, and many of us must be aware of many of the rights also, but still, in case of any doubt, all points will be clear after we had finished this lesson. And what to do if you are cheated by any manufacturer, or where to go, means what are the rules and laws to support us as a consumer or buyer of goods and services. So these are the things we are going to study in this lesson. And now let's start with the meaning. So the meaning says, the consumer protection refers to protecting the consumer against anti-consumer trade practices by the producer or seller. So first thing is consumer. So student, make note of one thing here. As the word consumer is used, means the one who is actually using the product and will not include if anyone is purchasing it for resale, like the retail store person. They purchase the goods for resale. So this is not for them. This is basically for the consumer. Clear? Means it is all about the protection of consumer. So consumer protection, it refers protecting the consumer against anti-consumer trade practices. What are these anti-consumer trade practices, like adulteration or some product of not good quality? So these are certain anti-consumer trade practices which are used by the producer or the seller. So just because of these things, consumer protection has been made. So now let's see the importance. So student, when any such kind of protection is being given to the consumer, means when any product is manufactured, so definitely it is manufactured for the consumer. Okay, consumer is going to use that particular product. And when it is affecting, means when it is beneficial for the consumer, then definitely direct or indirect way, it will also affect the business also. So therefore, this importance of consumer protection is from the point of view of consumer as well as from the point of view of business. So let's see what are the points. So the points are, from the consumer point of view, first, consumer ignorance, unorganized consumer, widespread exploitation of consumer. And from the point of view of business, long-term business interest, business uses resources of society, social responsibility, moral justification, and government intervention. So let's see all the points one by one. So first, let's start with from consumer point of view. So consumer ignorance, majority of consumers are not aware of their rights and reliefs available to them, as a result of which they are continuously exploited. So what happens when means nowadays we the consumer, we are aware, but what about the in earlier days? They were not that much aware. So these act were made to aware the consumer, because until and unless consumers are not aware, there will be unfair trade practices used. I'll give you one example of consumer awareness, as now there is a right given to consumer of non-payment of service charges in restaurant. Okay, means when we go to the restaurant and we used to have their lunch, dinner or brunch, whatever. So after we had all these things, we get the receipt for the payment. Okay, there service charge is mentioned over there. Okay, so now it is not mandatory. Now the service charges payment is voluntary payment. means now one can approach consumer court if the restaurant insists on payment of these service charge. So earlier, because of these consumer ignorance, such kind of things, the consumer were exploited. But nowadays, no, it won't. Then the second point says unorganized consumer. In India, consumers are still unorganized and there is lack of consumer organization which would act in their interest. As all are not aware of the rights, means all of us, we are not aware what all rights have been given to us, which we have, mean as a consumer we are having. And for such awareness, several consumer organizations are working in order for the adequate protection required to be given to consumer and also to promote the interest of the consumer. Clear? Then the next point is widespread exploitation of consumer. Consumers are exploited on large scale. Consumer protection is required to protect them from exploitation. So again, why this what is the importance of this consumer protection? Because of the widespread exploitation of the consumer. Exploitation was done by unfair trade practices or by false and misleading advertisement. False and misleading advertisement is like, suppose what happens when we see ad of any cream company saying that once you will use this cream, your skin will be white. So it is a kind of misleading advertisement, isn't it? Or by selling defective and unsafe product, like suppose the product is not up to the mark and the seller, they are selling such kind of product, so it may harm the consumer also after purchasing the such kind of product. So just to save the consumer from these exploitation, consumer need protection. Clear? Now let's see from the point of view of business. So long-term business interest. It is always in the interest of the business to keep its customers satisfied. Satisfied customers lead to repeat sales and thus helps in increasing customer base of the business. So now when business are taking all such steps to protect consumer, then it will lead to get good feedback. Feedback in the sense of what? Means when I am being a business person, I am selling any product and my customer, they are satisfied. So definitely when once the customer is satisfied, they are going, means they will tell 2-10 more people about my product. And when they are satisfied with some of the product, again they will prefer to buy the same product, isn't it? So when Laws is maintaining quality product, they are gaining trust of the customer, and so they win customer loyalty, which will help in customer sustainability. So firm should aim for customer protection, which is in the long term interest of business. Means once my customer is satisfied, definitely my business will go forever. Otherwise, what will happen? These consumer forum and all, they will group together and being a business person, I have to shut down my business. So for my interest only, it is good for me only. Like being a business person, it is in my favor only. Then the second point says business uses resources of society. Every business uses the resources of the society and thus it is their responsibility to work in the society's interest. As we all know, if we are doing business, we'll do it in society, means using society's resources. So for manufacturing any product, you are using society's resources, and because you are using these resources, you should provide good output or product for the society. Clear? Then the third point says the social responsibility. A business has social responsibilities towards various groups like owners, workers, government, customers. Thus, customers should be provided with quality goods at reasonable price. Means like responsibility towards the different groups are workers, means the business person, they should provide better salary, better wages to these workers. The working condition should be good. Then for the government, they should pay tax on time. For the customer, they should give good quality product. The product should not be hazardous. Okay, so these are certain social responsibility of a business person. Then moral justification. It is the moral duty of any business to act in favor of consumer interest and avoid any form of exploitation and unfair trade practices. Means being a business, being a businessman, one should have some moral values. So one should take care of that. Such moral values should be justified. It is duty of business person to ensure customer and not to exploit them through product, price, advertising. They should not mislead or misguide the customer. Like many times it happens, as I have already given you an example of cream, that the company, they say that after using so and so cream of my company, the people of means having dark complex complexion, they will be getting fair in color. So one should not do such thing. One should avoid doing such things. Then government intervention is the last point. That is, if a business engages in any form of unfair trade practices, then government takes action against it, which will adversely affect the goodwill of the company. Because if you are doing some unfair trade practices or using adulterated product, so it will invite government, and that company may come under the spotlight of the law. So this is also one reason why companies should avoid malpractices of any kind. So students, these were all the importance of consumer protection from the point of view of the consumer as well as from the point of view of business person. So I hope I made it clear. And student, please do like, share and subscribe the video, and comment if you have any kind of doubt. You can ask me through comment box. And thank you and take care.